were on that time scale and that size and had the neural system to pick up the emittance, you would see it as that. And they're demonstrating for you right there the consciousness of a molecule and an atom. Now, your mind works the same way. Interference patterns of certain amounts out of phase, turning on, turning off. So, what's the deal then? Well, if you have half of this consciousness that takes on one characteristic, regardless of how many different variances you have of it, they all match the other variances in the electron consciousness and as it relates to the nucleus. Half of that consciousness, the awareness to make decisions and change what it is, to interact with the other part of itself, the other part of the electrons, to interact. Half of an atom's consciousness, then, is there for it to perceive itself as I, the atom. The other half is used for something else. When atoms bond to each other, and what a covalent bond is the coupling of the complementary energies within an electron cloud that take on different dimensions and different characteristics. This is why if you study enough chemistry, you realize it's not just straight lines. The first bond is very basic. The other ones take on different dimensional traits that cannot be explained if you're looking at it from the third dimension. But say you have a group of atoms that come together to formulate a molecule. The part of them that are involved with bonding are used because they're conscious. They complement each other and interfere with each other to create what's called a scalar jump. And that other half of the atom's energy is used by the molecule to see itself as I, the molecule, while each atom still has half of its own consciousness to see itself as I, the atom. So it is both. It is a group of atoms that still see themselves as I, but part of something and know it, but maintain their individuality. And then you have a molecule that sees itself as I, utilizing the atoms. It's a different scale of existence. Then molecules can come together, because they're conscious, to formulate a tissue. Half of the consciousness of the molecule is used to see itself as I, the molecule. The other half is used by the tissue. Every molecule in the tissue itself, half of its consciousness is used by that tissue to perceive itself as I, the tissue. And all the molecules see themselves as I, the molecules. Understand that they are we, the molecules, being used willingly, of course, by the tissue, because they still have their own individuality. And the atoms within the molecules still perceive themselves as I, the atoms, but also we, the atoms, that are being used by the molecule to see itself as I, the molecule. They haven't lost any of their individuality because only half is the individuality. That's would be that way whether they're connected or not. So there's no reason, it's so perfectly designed, there's no reason to say I don't want that. Well, you can go up from tissues to, say, structures like organs. Same thing. You have a field of energy you can't perceive around it because, well, we'll get to that. Half of the consciousness around the organ, the field around it, sees itself as I, the organ, utilizing everything below it the same way. Another scalar jump. Every time you go from atom to molecule, it's a jump in scale. Go from molecule to tissue, it's a jump in scale. Tissue to organ, jump in scale. Well, the next stop is I, the body. You are using half of the consciousness of all the main components of your body, which are using half of the consciousness of all the things that make them up, and down and down and down. You're using half of the consciousness of your body to see yourself as I. I don't call myself we the cells, we the atoms, we the organs. I say I, Jonathan, right? Do you call yourself we? But you are we. And you are I. That consciousness innervates your body through different scales as well, because you have different scales of consciousness. You have the scale of your body, which, you know, innervates your body through large chakras. But if you go scale down, you have the other type of consciousness that goes through points of energy through organs, then cells right through the DNA. DNA in your cells are not the stopping point of DNA. You are part of DNA on a larger level. You're part, let me explain this. Up from you, what do you think the next jump up is? Your specific race of person. So it doesn't matter what race you are. This is why certain species have, quote, the same frequency. Just like organs will have the same frequency. So you go up to your race, and you have a consciousness that says, I, this race, utilizing half of each person involved in that race, half of their consciousness to do so. Then you go up from there, you have the human race, all the races combined. And half of the consciousness of all the races are used by the human race to see itself as I, the human race. Well, each race has its own identity, and then each person in the race has their own identity, and each organ within that person has its own identity, and down and down and down. You go up from there, and you have Earth with all the life forms on Earth. And yeah, half of the consciousness of all the life forms on Earth are used by the Earth to see itself as I, the Earth. When you go up from there, you have a solar system. The sun would be like a proton, and there is dark energy around the sun you can't see. Why? Because your eyes are part of the center energy, the part that's inside. So it's interacting with the wavelengths of energy that correlate to that. Protons, sun, light. This is why they would say in a song, blinded by the light. We'll get to that. And granted, this is all just on this wavelength, this bandwidth of existence that you're in. This is not, I'm just using an example of the bandwidth of existence that you can see. So what's around the sun is dark energy. That's what's keeping it in. That's what's surrounding the sun. As the dark energy interacts with the energy of the sun, it neutralizes it and creates orbitals, and that's where you would have the neutral energy or state of matter that life can exist, and that's what you would call the neutrons. Neutrons are only the interaction between these two types of energies, the outward male, which is sun, again, same properties, that's why they... Now you understand the Illuminati where they worship the sun, right? And they also worship the male phallus. Well, it's the same thing. It's the male energy. When they collide, you have that neutral point in between. If you go up to a galaxy, then all of the solar bodies in the galaxy would be the part of the, you know, that dense cluster of solar bodies inside. Be like the proton, and then you have dark energy around the galaxy. Now you can look up a dark energy map, and what you're going to find is that it only surrounds galaxies and connects all the galaxies together. Just like the electron energy connects all the atoms together to create molecules. You can't go from galaxy to galaxy unless you follow the path of the dark energy that connects them. But since it's all confluent and all one consciousness, then yes, you, if you...